Hi students, welcome to Morning Smart Class. This is your question discussion class of a probability chapter. What you learn from the concept class, we discuss that tricks and that rules in this questions. Come to the number, question number 1. Two cards are drawn together from a pack of 52 cards. The probability that one is spade and one is a heart. Two cards are drawn together from a pack of 52 cards. The probability that one is a spade and one is a heart. You know that there are two colors. One is a black suit, another is a red suit. In the red suit, one is a heart, then another is a diamond. In the black suit, one is a cloth, then another is a spade. So this is the 26 number, and it is 26 number, total number of cards 52. From the 52, black suit 26 cards, and red suit also 26 cards. Clear? From the 26 cards of a black suit, we get the 13, number of 13 cards is a club, number of 13 cards is spade. Same thing, heart is 13, number of cards 13, and a diamond also 13. Clear? Come to the question, there are 52 cards. Two cards are drawn, that is your 52C2. Number of samples, the number of events is equal to A spade card, total number of spade card here 13. This is your 13C1. Into, then a heart card also 13. And it is also 13C1. 13C1, 13 into 13C1, 13 divided by 52 into 51 divided by 2. 2 means it is a 26. 13 into 13 divided by 26 into 51. 13 2 is 13 by 2 1 is 2, 2 5 is 10. 102. 13 by 102. Option D is your correct answer. Question number 1 answer D. Come to the next number. Question number 2. One card is drawn at random from a pack of 52 cards. What is the probability that the card drawn is a face card? Face card means Jack, Queen and a King. One card is drawn at a random from a pack of 52 cards. Number of samples is 52C1. Jack, Queen and a King. You know that total number of cards 52. There are two colors. One is black, another is red. From the black, one is a cloth, another is a spade, okay? Then a red, heart and a diamond. Heart and diamond. It is 26 cards black and red, it is 26 cards. Then cloth 13, spade 13, heart 13, diamond 13. From the 13, Jack, Queen, King. These three cards are what? Face cards. In the 13 cloth card, we get a number of 3 cards here, face card. Then also 3 cards in the spade, face card. Heart, 3 cards in the heart, face card. And 3 cards in the diamond, it is also face card. Total number of face card in the pack of 52 cards, 3, 3, 6, 3, 9, 3, 12. This is your 12C1 divided by 52C1. 12C1 means you know that 12. Then 52C1, 52. 4 3 ja, then 4 13 ja. 3 by 13. 3 by 13 option A is your correct answer. Question number 2 answer A. Next number, question number 3. Question number 3. 3 unmatched coins are tossed. What is the probability of getting at least 2 heads? Total number of samples 8. Because 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8. So, questions to us, what is the probability of getting at least 2 heads? Head, head, tail, then tail, head, tail, then tail, head, head, then head, head, head. These are the four numbers we get here, 4 by 8. 4 4 by 8 means the probability is 1 by 2. So that option B is your correct answer. Question number 3 answer B. Next number, question number 4. From a pack of 52 cards, 3 cards are drawn. What is the probability that one is yes, one is queen and one is jack? So total number of cards are 52. There are 4 S in the total pack of cards. Because in the spade, we get 1 S. And a club, we get 1 S. Then your hat, we get 1 S. Then hat diamond, we also get 1 S. There are 4 S. Same thing, 4 queen. Then 4 jack. 4 jack. There are 52 cards, 3 cards are drawn, number of subpulls 52C3. Then 4C1, 1S, 4C1, 1 queen, 4C1, 1 jack, 4C1. So 4 into 4 into 4 divided by 4 into 4, 4 into 4 into 4 into 4 divided by 52C3. That means 52 factorial divided by 3 factorial. 52 minus 3, 49 factorial. That means 52 into 51 into 50 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. So here 3 is 17, 3 is 51. 2 26. Okay. 26 into 17 into 50. So 2 2 is 230. Then 2 2 is then 25. So here 4 2 is 8, 8 2 is 16 divided by 13 into 17 into 25. Then 13 into 17 into 25. 16 divided by 13 7 is 91, 109 carry. 13 1 is 39, 22, 221. 221 into 25, 25 1 is 25, 5 2 carry. 25 2 is 50 plus 2, 52, 25 carry. 25 is 50 plus 5, 55, 55, 25. 16 by 5525. Option B is your correct answer. Question number 5. A letter is taken out at random from assistant and another is taken out from statistics. The probability that they are the same letter is what? So here in the assistant A, then A. S, 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 then T, T, then I, then L. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. T, T, I, L. Okay, clear? Then, statistics. In the statistics, only one A, I write here A. Then S, 1, 2, 3, there are 3 S, 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 S. Then T, how many T here? 1, 1, 2, 3, there are 3 T. Then I, then C, I, C. 3, 1, 4, 4, 3, 7, 2, 9. Then another number, double I, statistics, II, 2I. Clear? The same number, so same number here A and here 2C1 by 9C1, 2C1 by 9C1 into 1C1 by 10C1, 10C1. That is your 2 by 90, 2 by 90. 2C1 means 2, 1C1 means 1, 2 into 1 is equal to 2, 9C1 it is a 9, 10C1 also 10, 10 9 is 90. Then S, there are 3 S, in the assistant there are 3 S. 3 S, so I write 3C1 by 9C1 into, and here 2S, 2S means, sorry, 3S, S, 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 3S, 3C1 by 10C1. So 3 by 90. Clear? Sorry, 9 by 90. Because 3C1 is 3 and 3C1 is 3. 3, 3 is 9, 9C1, 9, 10C1, 10. 10 into 9 is equal to 90. there are two T, 2C1 by 9C1 into 3C1 divided by 10C1. It is your 6 by 90. Then I 1C1 by 9C1 into 2C1 by 10C1. It is your 2 by 90. I here common. Clear? N and C there are no common. So I added all these numbers are this 2 by 90 plus 9 by 90 plus 9 by 90 plus 6 by 90 and 2 by 90. Okay. 6 by 90 plus 2 by 90. 9 to 11, 11, 6, 17, 17 to 19. The answer is 19 by 20. Answer is 19 by 20. Option B is your correct answer. Option B is your correct answer. This is your answer. 19 by 20. Clear? Come to the next number. A bag contains 2 red, 3 green and 2 blue balls. 2 balls drawn at random. What is the probability that none of the balls drawn is blue? None of the balls drawn is blue. So that 2 red, 3 green, that means there are 5 balls. 2 balls are drawn, 5C2. Number of samples 3, 2, 5, 2, 7, 7C2. 5C2 means 5 into 4 divided by 2. 2 2s are 5 2s are 10. 7C2, 7 into 6 divided by 2, 2 3s are, 7 3s are 21, 10 by 21, 10 by 21, this is your answer, 10 by 21, clear, option A is your correct answer. I bag 2 red, 3 green and 2 blue balls, 2 balls are drawn at random, what is the probability that none of the balls drawn is blue? Okay, 2 red and 3, 5C2 means 10. Then 7C2 means 7 into 6 divided by 3, 21. So that option A is your correct answer, 10 by 21. Come to the next number, question number 7. 3 coins are tossed. Find the probability of at least 2 heads. Find the probability of at least 2 heads. 3 coins are tossed means 2 to the power of 3, total number of samples are 8. At least 2 heads means head, tail, head. These are the 4 ways. That means 4 by 8. Answer is equal to 1 by 2. Question number 7 answer A. Next number, question number 8 answer. In a single throw for 3 dice. Find the probability of getting a total of 17 or 18. There are 3 dice means total number of samples. Total number of samples 6k is equal to 216. Find the probability of getting a total of 17 or 18. So 18 1 is possible, 6 plus 6 plus 6. Only one way. Okay. Then 17, 6 plus 6 plus 5. Okay. This is your 17. 6 plus 6 plus 5. One way. Then another 5, 6, 6. Then 5. Then 5. Sorry. 6, 5, 6. 6, 5, 6. If you added this number 5, 5, 5, no. Then only 6, 6, 5. Then 5, 6, 6, then 6, 5, 6. This is 3 and 1, 4. 4 by 216. 4 by 216 means 1 by 54. Option A is your correct answer. Question number 8 answer A. Clear? Question number 9. The probability that a contractor will get a plumbing contract is 2 by 3. And the probability that you will not get an electric contract is 5 by 9. Okay? The probability of getting at least one contract is 4 by 5. What is the probability that you will get both? You know that A union B is equal to ए सेट प्लस बी सेट माइनस ए इंटरसेक्शन बी सेट, ठीक है। सो हियर द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर विल गेट ए प्लम्बिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, प्लम्बिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट प्रोबेबिलिटी इज 2/3 एंड इलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्ट्रैक्ट गेटिंग पॉसिबिलिटी इज 1 - 5/9, इट इज योर 4/9, क्लियर। सो ए यूनियन बी इज इक्वल टू, आई राइट हियर ए यूनियन बी, दिस इज योर 4/5। इफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग एटलीस्ट वन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज 4/5, so 4/5 is equal to a is your 2/3 plus b is equal to 4/9 minus a intersection b, clear, minus a intersection b. What is the probability that he will get both? So here 4/5 is equal to, its LCM is 9, 3 3 is 9, 3 2 is 6, plus then 9 is 4, minus a intersection b. So A intersection B is equal to 4/5 minus 10/9. Sorry, 10/9 minus 4/5. 10/9 minus 4/5. 10/9 minus 4/5. You will take LCM here 45. 9 5 is 45. 10 5 is 50. Then 5 9 is 36. 50 minus 36, 14/45. 14/45. Option C is your correct answer. Question number 9, answer C. Clear? Come to the next number. 3 coins are tossed. Find the probability of exactly 2 heads. 3 coins are tossed means the number of samples is equal to 2^3 is equal to 8. Why we take here 2^3? Because in one coin, one is head, another is tail. There are 2 possibilities. So 2^3, there are number of possibilities is 8 each. But we have to find out the exactly 2 head. That means head, head, tail, tail, head, tail, then tail, head, head. This is only 3 possibilities. The answer is what? 3/8. Option A is your correct answer. 10 answer A. Next number, question number 11. 2 dice are thrown together. What is the probability that the sum of the number on 2 faces in neither 9 nor 11? In neither 9 nor 11. The number of samples 6^2 is equal to 36. What is the probability that the sum of the number on 2 face in neither 9 or not 11? So 9 means there are 2 dice, 1 is 3 and 6, 6 into 3, 6 and 3, 6 plus 3, 9, 3 plus 6, 9. Then 4, 5, 5, 4. There are 4 possibilities to find the sum of the 2 face of a cube, okay. Sorry, face of a cube or dice, then 11. 11 means there are 2 possibilities. One is 6 and 5, then 5 and 6, 2. So 4/36 plus 2/36. 4/36 means 1/9 plus 2/36 means 1/18. Then it is 18, 9 to 18, 2 plus 1, 3/18. 3/18 means 1/6. The possibility of getting either 9 or 11, this is your 1/6. And not possibility getting 9 or 11, 1 - 1/6. The answer, it is your 5/6. Option B is your correct answer. 11 answer B. But you find here, 3/18, 1/6. 3/18 is equal to 1/6. This 1/6 is possibility for getting 9 and 11. Sum of the 2 face of the cube 9 and 2 face of the cube also 11. Or 2 face of the dice or 2 face of the 2 face of the dice is 9 and 2 face of the dice is 11. Clear? 1 - 1/6, so my answer is what? 5/6. Question number 12. From a pack of 52 cards, 3 cards are drawn. What is the probability that one is ace, one is queen, and one is jack? This question is also repeated question. 52C3,
52C3
total number of samples. Then S 4C1 into 4C1 into 4C1 divided by 52C3. Answer is here 16.5525. Come to the next number, question number 13. Two dice are tossed. The probability that total score is a prime number. Total score is a prime number. Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. These are the prime numbers. Then when we get the 2, there is one chances. 1 plus 1. In one dice we get 1, then another dice we get 1. The sum of the two numbers is 2, prime number. 3, 2 and 1, 1 and 2. There are 2 chances. Because in one dice you will get 2, then in another dice you will get 1, the sum is prime number 3. What 2, 1 or 1, 2. Then 5. 5 means 4, 4, 1, 1, 4, 2, 3, 3, 2. 7. 7 means here 1, 6, 6, 1, 5, 2, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3. 11. 5, 6, 6, 5. This is only one chance for only 2. Only 2 we get one chance. One chance. Then 2, 1, 1, 2, there are 2 chances. These are the 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 chances. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 chances. 1, 2, 2 chances. Okay, clear. 2 dice are tossed, the probability that the total score is a prime number. So 2, 1, 3, 4, 3, 7, 6, 13 to 15. 15 by 36. 15 by 36, 3, 5 is a 312 is a 5 by 12 option B is your correct answer. Question number 15 answer B. Come to the next number. Question number 14. A card is drawn from a pack of 52 cards. The probability of getting a digit card of a club or a king of heart is what? So there are 52 cards. From the 52 cards, a card is drawn. A single card is drawn. The number of samples 52C1. The probability of getting a digit card. A digit card means there are 52 cards. There are two color cards. One is black, then another is red. In the black, one is spade, another is club. In the red, one is heart and another is diamond. So in the spade card, total there are 13 cards. Each group 13 cards. From the 13, there are 4 honors card. If 4 honors card, the rest cards are called digit cards. So here 9 are digit cards. In this 9, 9, 9. So total 9, 9, 18, 9, 27, 9, 36. There are 36 cards, digit cards. So here 36 is 1 divided by 52 is 1. That is your 36 by 52. 36 by 52. Clear? Or a king of heart. Or a king of heart. In the heart card, only one king. So I write here 1C1 divided by 52C1. 1 by 52. This is your 1 by 52. According to the question, 36 by 52 plus 1 by 52 is equal to 37 by 52. Option E is your correct answer. 14 answer D. Come to the next number. 15 number. A bag contains 3 green and 7 white balls. 2 balls are drawn from the bag in succession without replacement. What is the probability that both are white? So here both are white. 7C1 by 10C1 into 6C1 divided by 9C1. So that 7 by 10 into 6 by 9. 2 3 ja, then 2 5 ja. 3, 3 is a, the answer is what? 7 by 15. So option D is your correct answer. Then come to the next number. Question number 16. 2 balls are to be drawn from a bag of containing 8 grey and 3 blue balls. Find the chance that they will be both blue. Find the chance that they will be both blue. 2 balls are drawn. 2 balls are drawn to be drawn. From a bag of containing 8 grey and 3 blue balls, find the chance that they will be both blue. So here total number of balls blue 3. That is your 3C2 divided by 11C2. 3C2 means 3 factorial into 2 factorial, sorry, 3 into 2 divided by 2. 11C2 means 11 into 10 divided by 2. 2 cancels, 2 5 is a 3 y, 55. So option D is your correct answer. Clear? Come to the next number, question number 17. A bag contains 4 black balls, 5 red balls. If 3 balls from the bag are chosen at random, what is the chance that they are all black? They are all black means 4C3 divided by total number of balls here, 5 red and 4 black, 9C3. 4C3 means 4 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 1 factorial. That is your 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 1 factorial. 3 factorial cancel, it is 4. 9C3 means 9 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 9 minus 3, 6 factorial. So 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1. 3 3 ja, then 2 4 ja. Okay, 4 3 ja 12, 12 7 ja 84. 84 by 84, 4 by 84 means 1 by 21. So 1 by 21, option D is your correct answer. Then come to the next number, question number 18. A problem is given to 3 persons PQR whose respective chances of solving it are 2 by 7, 4 by 7, 4 by 9 respectively. What is the probability that the problem is solved? A problem is given to 3 persons PQR whose respective chances of solving 2 by 7. Chances of solving 2 by 7. Chances not solving, it is your 5 by 7. 5 by 7. 1 minus 2 by 7 is equal to 5 by 7. Not solving, it is the chances of the not solving. So same thing, it is 4 by 7 chances to solve. Not solve, it is your 3 by 7. 4 by 9, it is your chances to solve. Not solve, it is your 5 by 9. According to the question, 1 minus 5 by 7 into 3 by 7 into 5 by 9. So here the 5 by 7, 3 by 7 into 5 by 9. 3 3 ja, then 1 minus 5 5 ja 25, then 7 7 ja 49 into 3. 3 9 ja 27, 7 2 carry 3 4 ja 12 to 14, 147. 147 minus 21, 1 minus 21 by 147. So that 147 minus 21 by 147. 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. 14 minus 2 is equal to 12. 1 2 6 by 1 4 7. 126 by 147. 5 5 is at 25. Sorry. 5 5 is at 25. This value here 25. 21 minus 25 by 147. This is your 25 and it is also 25. 7 minus 5 is equal to 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, 14 minus 2 is equal to 12. 122 by 147. 122 by 147, option A is your correct answer. Clear? Come to the next number, question number 19. Find the probability of getting 2 heads when 5 coins are tossed. When 5 coins are tossed, the number of samples is equal to, you know that number of samples is equal to 2 to the power 5. 2 to the power 5 means 2 into 2, 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 to the 32. But we have to find out the probability of getting 2 heads. There are 5 heads. In 5 coins, we get only 5 heads. So that we need the 2. When we get 2 heads, find the probability of getting 2 heads when 5 coins are tossed. When 5 coins are tossed, the total number of samples 2 to the power 5 is equal to 32. So here we need only 2 heads. The number of total heads 5. 5C2. 5C2 means 5 into 4 divided by 2. 2 2 is 5 2 is 10. 10 by 32. 10 by 32 means 2 5 is 2 16 is 5 by 16. So option A is your correct answer. Find the probability that a leap year has 53 Sundays. Question number 2. 1 year 365 days. And in the leap year, there are 366 days. Okay? It is in 1 year, this is just 365 days. In the leap year, in one leap year, total number of days 316. How many weeks? 366 divided by 7. 7, 5 is 35. Then 16, 7, 2 is 14. The remainder is 2. These 2 may be Sunday or Monday. Then Monday or Tuesday. Then Tuesday. Then Wednesday. Then Wednesday. Thursday. Thursday. Friday. Friday. Saturday. Then Saturday. Sunday. Clear? So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 chances. But Sunday in the first day, Sunday, Monday, and also we get here last Sunday, there are 2 chances for getting the Sunday. That is your 2 by 7. Option B is your correct answer. This is your probability chapter, question discussion class. Try to understand all the questions and make a note, read again and again. Then it will be very easy to solve all the questions of this chapter. This is the very important chapter. Definitely you will get 1 or 2 questions in any exam. Okay. Thank you very much. Bye.